together on this 16th Sunday of Ordinary Time, gathering our prayer in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Standing before God's word, gathered before the altar, we are mindful of our frailty, our weakness, and our sin, and we ask God for mercy and forgiveness. You were sent to heal and forgive those who are sorry for their sin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You nourish and strengthen us with word and sacrament. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are our advocate, pleading for us at God's right hand. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weaknesses. For we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings. And the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
First, collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn. The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field, but while everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away." It may be asked, "Didn't you sow good seed in your field?" We know somewhere deep in the earth of our souls, God did and does sow good seed in us. How can we look into the face of a child not see God's hand? How can we not see the depth of love in our parish family when death visits one of our own? How can a parent cradle their infant not believe God can be trusted? There are times when we confess our faith in Christ, standing deep in a river of tears, and through our sorrow, confessing God is great, God is good, God is love. But the question lingers, where do the weeds come from? personal and collective sinfulness. The Apostle James writes, "Where do these conflicts, weeds, come from? Is it not from your passion, your sins, that make war within your members?" So we must take on weed control. Our Lord offers us a way to deal with the weeds in our lives. Let us spend our lives nurturing the gospel. Love those whose lives seem choked by weeds. Comfort the confused. Sit patiently with the grieving. Surprise the cynic with a positive gesture. Send gospel flowers rather than weeds. Let gospel flowers grow within our own lives. Watch the weeds shrivel away until the day when God will take them all away. Amen. Let us together then make our profession of faith with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Standing now before the Lord, let us express some of our needs in our prayer. Faithful.
For the Church, that we may reveal God's mercy in the way we come to the assistance of those in trouble, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in authority, that they judge with mildness and govern with forbearance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish may be welcoming to all and judging to no one, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, that we may find comfort in God's extravagant mercy, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who await mental, physical, emotional, and spiritual healing, that God's grace may touch them and bring them healing, including Rita Visnon, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the departed may rejoice as they are called into fellowship with Christ, including Irene Christensen, wife of the late James Christensen, Donna Real, Chester Shimolewski, husband of Marianne Shimolewski, Charles Beck, husband of Rose Beck, and Cecilia Visnon, twin of Rita. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. As a worshiping community, we are united with our family and faith, and together we pray for the following intentions: Bernard and Cecil, Peter Vitale, Robert Doobie, Angeline Tringali, Josephine Ortiz. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. Lord God, may the gospel message flower within our lives so that we might choke out the weeds that keep us from being true disciples of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray, for he lives with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, our loving and almighty Creator. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you bless the gift of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, and through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, Father, he has opened the gates of heaven. And so, with company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise. On us all, we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, our Lady of Hope, her husband Joseph, with the Apostles, Saint Germain, Saint Gertrude, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, for Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, in fellowship of favor, we pray as he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, so that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, and the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, and you say to us, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us now go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks
be to God.